Now, apart from satellites, apart from tracking, there is one more way people have invented. In fact, I would say it's the most ingenious way of working with OpenStreetMap. And that is called field papers. So now Amit will tell you more about what are field papers.
I mean, all of you must have had geography in your school time, right? So you are asked to make a map of, from your school to your home, let's say. So can you make that kind of map even now? Okay. You make a map and then you import that map that you have made with your hand onto the OSM thing. So field papers is about that. So it provides you with a satellite map, satellite images of that area. And what you do is you walk around with that page, printed page that you have. And that printed page, then you mark on that printed page. Okay, so let's say you walk down this lane, then there is a shop there. So you mark that shop on that map. Okay, so this is this shop. Then you go further, then there is a medical store, you mark that. So all these markings you do on the paper, you take a scan of this particular paper, or you take a photo of this particular paper and upload it onto the field papers site. So once you upload this, this handwritten notes of yours will be available for you in the map. So once you have these printouts, you give them out to the students. So students will mark places on this paper and then they can upload it back to this site. Okay. I'll show you how to make the pages. So let's say I again go to Nagpur in this case. So this is the current area. This is very large area actually. This almost covers entire town. I don't want it to be that large. Okay, so I can reduce it here. So let's say you decide upon that this particular area is not marked in your map. In the satellite images, this area is not marked. Okay, so you take your rectangles to that particular area, and so then you can decide upon with the students that this batch of students will do this particular area, and if you want to add, you can add more pages like this. Okay, so I'll say Nagpur West. I'll just choose the UTM grid overlay and it says finished. Okay, so it's preparing my atlas now, and we'll see.
The atlas gives you few options. One is only map you want, or you want also an area where you can take the notes, or you want map plus notes or map without notes. So what you get is an A4 sheet. Half of the A4 sheet would be map and the remaining half would be just a blank white paper.
So it says download PDF. Okay, so this is the map that is currently there. In this, I mean, you have multiple options for the background. Well, first one is the OpenStreetMap. So if there is nothing in your town, nothing will come out there. Better option would be satellite only or satellite plus labels. Okay, so that way, I mean, you'll have a satellite map printed onto a paper.
I'm going to give an assignment now. Should I? Okay, the assignment is as follows. Go to the place where you like, anywhere on the earth. I mean, it could be the same place where you are already making some maps. Go to fieldpapers.org. You can use the same user ID that you have already used on osm.org. So what is it that you have to do? Go to your area, create 2 or 4 pages of the field papers and create one PDF file with 3 or 4 pages. Okay. Name the PDF accurately, because field papers will create the name of the file automatically. After you downloaded the PDF file onto your machine, rename the file. You know, based on, let us say it is Nagpur West field papers. So what you now do is, you have to go to your area on studio.tis.edu and you have to upload this PDF. Print it, take it in your hand, start walking on the road. Okay, this is ATM, HDFC Bank. Go a little further and then mark on the paper. It's very easy, very commonsensical, so easy to map, accurate, because on the background you have the very light colored satellite map. On top you take a pen and directly write on top of it. And let me tell you, if you do it properly, you will take at least 2 days to fill one field paper. It is that much of data here. So what you have to do is, you have to tell, let's say if you are giving C1 paper to a student, let's say this is one student group, I'm giving all of them C1, and I tell them, okay, on the C1 you make, let's say 3 areas, mark like this, and then say C1A will be done by him, C1B will be done by him, C1-3 will be done by him. Only thing that you have to do is that on each page, at least identify one landmark before the students leave the college for the field work. There will be a lot of pen writings, right? I don't know how many of you have seen this paper? All of you have seen it, right? Did you notice that there is a small box here? QR code. Now, what is the advantage of this QR code? Just take a picture using your mobile or maybe your camera, digital camera. Take a picture and then transfer that picture, upload the picture to fieldpapers.org. Then, because this code is there and you have these dots also, that means even if your picture is slightly distorted, because you know this paper is very nice now, but not after the field work. After the field work, this paper will be, you know, quite crumpled. You know, you might have done like this. You can do all that, no problem. After everything is done, just keep it on a paper, take a picture. Okay, because these dots will help the software to do the processing and keep it exactly at the place where that background should go. And now you see, lines are there, dots are there, and areas are marked. Because you are doing exactly these 3 things, you will have the entire notes on your screen. Now start filling and typing the area. If there is a line there, you just mark the line. Start line, end line, make the line, and then write down the, suppose you know the road name, you write down the road name. If there is a rectangle which is a medical shop, then make that rectangle and then say this is a medical shop. So there are many ways you can contribute to OSM. Our experience is that almost all the students who have done the field papers work, they're very happy. They draw a line, they see the line there. That is positive feedback for all the children. You don't have to tell them, and you don't have to give them any marks. Marks is already given by the OSM because they have already seen their data, it's alive.
हे बघ ना इथून जायचं
पण जे स्कूल थोडंसं तिकडे आहे पण आता ह्या घराच्या समोर हे घर आहे
आपण इथे निघणार परत हा रस्ता बघ
इथून तो हायवेला जातो इकडचा तो रस्ता जातो ना तो हायवेला आता आपल्याला इथून टर्न घ्यायचा आहे इथे जायचं आहे हा हायवे कॉलेज कडचा
आहे इकडे रस्ता दिसतच नाही
हा
रस्ता कुठून करू आपण नेम आणि हे
बघ ना ही जागा आहे ना ती ही आहे जी आहे
इथून ATM आहे आणि त्याच्या पुढे एक ॲक्सिस बँकेचं ATM आहे तर जिकडे जिकडे मेन असं दिसेल ना तिकडे असं गोल करून करायचं आणि झेरोक्स काढ आणि हे तुझ्याकडे ठेव त्यांना रिटर्न द्यायचं
आहे शो समथिंग फ्रॉम तलासरी सो दिस इज अ फील्ड पेपर ऑफ तलासरी अँड वन ऑफ द स्टुडंट्स हॅज मार्क्ड क्वाईट अ लॉट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन दिस फील्ड पेपर सो यू कॅन सी डिफरंट नंबर्स रिटन ओवर हियर सम टेक्स्ट ही हॅज ॲडेड Okay, so like this is quite a very, so this is a guy called Ashraf Sheikh. So he's added quite a lot of objects there. And on back of this, he has written out what those numbers are. Okay, so these numbers can be seen that like 17 number is Nikum, 18 number is Tata Tower and all that. Okay, so once you upload this file, this is how it appears in the field papers. Okay, so I'll just zoom into this thing. And you can see this is what he has marked as BP. Okay, so this is the Bharat Petroleum. And here he has put a point called Bharat Petroleum. Okay, so this is how you have to edit using the field papers thing. And if you go below, so this he has marked as hospital. So he has put a point of hospital there. So once you upload the file, it will automatically find the location of that, where that PDF was created for. And it will take you to that place. It will ask you whether you want to edit it. When you go to edit, you will get a file as background instead of the satellite images. So one more thing I wanted to show you, this is from Talasari again. So this is how Talasari looked on the map before we went there. ओके यू कॅन सी ओनली द हायवे. सो द मुंबई अहमदाबाद हायवे पासेस थ्रू तलासरी.
यू हॅव नो ट्रेस ऑफ द टाउन देअर.
ओके सो देर वॉज नथिंग देअर. आय मीन ॲक्च्युली लिटरली नथिंग. यू कॅन सी इट हिअर. देन दिस इज अबाउट अ मंथ लेटर इन फेब्रुवारी 1st. आय मीन सम रोड्स हॅव बीन ॲडेड. दिस इज द कॉलेज अँड सम स्कूल हॅज बीन ॲडेड. सम रोड्स हॅव बीन ॲडेड अँड दिस इज मच लेटर. ओके सो दिस इज अबाउट अ मंथ लेटर अगेन. सो यू कॅन सी द रिचनेस ऑफ द इन्फॉर्मेशन. And about 40% or 50% of the students come from nearby villages. So this road now continues till like 15-20 kilometers ahead. They have taken it to their villages where they come from. They added schools in their villages and all that. So this was a very enriching experience for them also.
All the people who visit that area will see that line. And if they have an account, they'll be able to see who contributed that line. So one of the interesting thing that happens in free software, unlike in proprietary software, is every contribution, every small contribution goes into the history book. Everybody's name is there. What they did, when they did, is all recorded. Wikipedia, for example. I don't know how many of you visited Wikipedia. It's a stupid question to ask. The moment you search, you'll end up on Wikipedia. Now the second question I'm asking, how many of you know that there is something called a talk page? Every page has a talk page. Click on any article. Yeah, let's say Geological Gardens. You see the article and then there is talk. So talk page is a place where all the contributors who are contributing to that page are negotiating with each other. Discussing with each other. The free software community, the geek community, is documenting history so meticulously. They're telling how it is made. People don't have information of how anything is made. We only know that particular paper is published. Some software is made. Some car is manufactured. But the process of making is not documented. You know, there's a very interesting way how the social transformation is possible through this kind of digital literacy. So this digital literacy can transform people into makers. And then the footprints of those makers is left as traces in the cyber world.
So right now I'm seeing the Mumbai talk page and you can see all the discussions that are happening in the Mumbai talk page. There are about 15 pages. I mean, it's so long.
Okay, now is the time for all of you to make a field paper, 2 or 4 page PDF, and you have to upload on studio.tis.edu. So like that, you'll be able to do a lot of work on the field paper. So there are many ways you can contribute to OSM.